In this tutorial, we're going to look at how to create out these two amazing abstract designs in Adobe Illustrator. So for the first design, what we have done is we have created a stroke lines, duplicated it and applied make with mesh options and added some anchor points. And we have used die selection to adjust the anchor points to give this nice curvy look at the end, create a duplicate, and after that clipped it into a circular shape. For the second design, what you have done is we have created this using a rectangular shape, or you can use the stroke to create a multiple number of duplicates, right? And after that, we have first way is using the Pathfinder tool, where I have divided the shape into two and selected those anchor points and use the transform tool to scale or rotate it. The second way is using the make with mesh options, and we can create a design something like this. So let's begin with our designing process. So to create our first design, let's create these parallel lines. So we're gonna use the line tools. So I'm gonna use the line segment tool, right? And just click and drag and create a straight line. Okay, something like this. Let's add a stroke color. Let's choose white color and increase the stroke thickness to around, let's say around 7. And we're gonna go to stroke and we'll make this pointed one. So over here under profile, you can see we got some shapes here, unique shapes. You can choose any of it. For this design, what I want is I want this rectangular kind of shape where I want this broader here and pointed at the bottom, and I can anytime adjust the thickness. So I'll just keep it around 8 points. Okay, now I'll create a duplicate. So with the alt click and drag and with the shift press, you can just slide it to a straight line, something like that. This will snap parallel to it. So I'll just place it around here and we'll create a duplicate. So Command or Control D to create multiple number of duplicates, right? Something like this. And there we go. We have created that parallel lines. I want to select everything. First of all, I'll just lock these background shapes. So select these and Command or Control 2 to lock the background or shape. Very easy. The shortcut is Command or Control 2. Now select these, right? And what I'll do is I'll just apply the make with mesh option. So for that, I'll go to object and go to envelope distort and make with mesh options, and under here we got these envelope mesh panel. Here we can decide how many rows or how many columns you want to add to create the mesh. For this design, what I want is I want minimal, so I'll just reduce it. So I'll reduce the rows to 2 and columns to, let's say, 1. Very minimal. Okay, so this is what I want over here. And I'll just click OK. Now what I'll do is I'll just select these two anchor points. So using direct selection tool over here, right? The shortcut is A. Select these two anchor points. With the arrow key, up arrow key, just push it up with the shift press, right? And with the side arrow key, just slide it on the right side. Something like this. Very simple. Now I'll just use the direct selection tool. Select these anchor points, right? Click here and just make it like curve, something like that. Go over here as well and make it along the flow. There we go. Now I'll just go over here, right? And I'll just make sure they are on this side. These two, I'll just shift it a little bit more and a little bit upward just to give that nice, you can see this curve. So it's here, you can do the adjustments, right? So I'll just push it a little bit up and sideways, and there we go. And you can easily adjust the handles to give it more curve if you want to add more curviness. And here I'll do a little bit of adjustments here. I want to just add a little bit of angle, so select the handles and give it a little bit of angle, something like that, just to give that little bit a smoother and curvier look to that. And there we go, we got that nice pattern here. Okay, after this, what I'll do is I'll just create a duplicate. So with the alt or option press, click and drag and create a duplicate, and we'll just rotate this. So selecting the shape, if you go at the corner, you can see this circular icon, right? Just click and with the shift press, just snap and just make the rotation, and there we go. Now we'll place it somewhere around here. Just zoom it in and place it somewhere around here. And I think this looks fine. Now just create a circle on top. So we'll use the ellipse tool over here. Okay, and with the shift and alt and option key press, click and drag to create a perfect circle. After creating a circle, we'll select these two, group this up, Command Control G, right? We'll place this on top, and with the shift press, just scale it up a little bit more, place it around here. Now select these two shapes, selecting a design and the circle. Okay, with the shift press, right click and make with clipping mask. So click clipping mask and this will clip your design to the circle. And after this, I'll just zoom it in, double click and go inside and adjust the position a little bit. Okay, you can just scale down a little bit if you want to make it a little bit smaller. Okay, and place it around there, and there we go. We have created that amazing circular design, abstract design, and it was very simple, very easy. So over here, what we have seen is we have used the make with mesh options to give this circular curvy at the end, and I have applied clipping mask to a circle to give this circular look. Now let's look at how to create this second design. It's very simple, so let's begin. So there are two ways to create out this shape. One is using the stroke and another is using the rectangular shape. First, I'll show you the rectangular shape way. So let's select the rectangle tool, right, and just click and drag and create a rectangle, something like this. Okay, and I'll just fill this up with black color. Okay, now I'll create a duplicate. So it's very simple, with the Alt or Option key press, click and drag it down. And once you have created one duplicate, it's very easy to create multiple number of duplicates. So use the shortcut Command or Control D multiple number of times and this will create a duplicate. And I think this looks fine. Okay, now I'll select everything, right, and place it over here. If you see over here, you can see I have created a division. I have created this like perspective look by extending these anchor points. So what I want is I want these some anchor points at these corners. So first way is using the Pathfinder tool. I'll select these, right? Okay, I'll add a line segment tool at the center. So just click and drag it down. Okay, that's way. And now selecting all these, right, with the line and these shapes, we'll go to Pathfinder over here, or you can go to Windows and you can find the Pathfinder. Here is the Pathfinder. Okay, just click on it. And now over here, just click on divide and this will divide your shapes into two pieces. And here you got your anchor points. What I'll do is I'll just select the direct selection tool. Okay, and select these anchor points. Very simple. Now we're going to use the transform tool. So we'll go over here and here you can see free transform tool. Just click on it and here you got four options. I'm going to use the second one. And if you go over here, hover over here, you can see this icon over here. Just okay, this one. So just click and drag and this will push it down or extend it. Very simple. And if you press Alt and Option key, you can see it will give the effect to both side and this will give you that symmetric look. So I want this shape, so I'll just press Alt or Shift and then click and drag it up. Very simple. Now if you want to give a rotation, if you go at the corner, you can just click and you can give that rotation. Very simple, right? And I'll just extend it a little bit more. Okay, and make the rotation on this side and I think this looks good and I think I'm okay with this design. You can adjust the design shape, adjust the size and place it, and there we go. Now if you want to create the second design, something like this, we're gonna use this second option, that is make it mesh option. So I'm gonna again create under shape. So this time I'm gonna use the line segment tool, this one, line segment tool, right? Just click and drag a line. Okay, fill this up with stroke color black. Very simple. Let's add a thickness. So around, let's say around this much. Okay, and I'll just place it around here. Now to create a multiple number of duplicates, I'm going to use a different option. So what I'll do is I'll select this line segment, go to effect, distort and transform. And here I'm going to go to transform option. Here it's very simple. Just add number of copies. Let's say 10 or maybe 6. And here you can scale or move, and here I want is move, so I'm going to move it to vertical. So if you move down vertical, you can add these number of duplicates. So I'm going to place it, let's say around this much, and I think this looks good. Okay, now after that, go to object and expand the appearance. Very simple. Now I'm going to use the mesh tool, so make it mesh option. So selecting that, go to object, envelope distort, make with mesh option. Very simple. And in the same way, we'll adjust the rows and columns. So here what I want is I want the column to around this much and the rows to 1, and click OK. Now we're going to use the direct selection to select these two anchor points. Okay, and again using the transform tool, here free transform tool, and with the Alt and Option key pressed on your keyboard, just click and drag and you can like edges this, something like this. You can see you can make it narrow or broader and this will give you the symmetric design looking, and as you can see, it's giving that nice Doppler effect design. So something like this. And if you want to give a rotation, you just go to the side and just click, and you can give that rotation. You can adjust the size, click and drag, and you can make it narrow or extend it. Very simple, right? Now we can even tweak the handles. So I'm going to use the die selection tool, and you can just go to handles and give some interesting look to your design, something like this, right? And if you want to break the anchor point, you can go to pen tool here and choose anchor point tool and just click okay and just break this, or maybe just go over here and break the handles. Very simple. Again, go over here, click and break the anchor points, something like that, and you got that some interesting looking design very easily. And that's how we have created these two amazing abstract design. First one using the make it mesh option and clipping it to a circle, and the second design we have used the make it mesh option, we have applied Pathfinder tool to give that division in the center. We have used the free transform tool to adjust the anchor points, either scaling it up or narrowing down rotation. Very easy to use, and using that we have created this second design. So you can use this same tool and create out your own designs. Very simple. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up, and if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share and subscribe this channel. So see you in the next video.